ako lang yan. May sinendo kong may sinendo kong file, kakasend lang, so pwede paki-download din.
Debo.
So paki-check na sa ano, sa hala. Ah, sorry.
Ayun po.
Yeah. Medyo malaking sa pa-download. Tapos yan yung gagawin kasi natin ngayon. That's for the yung parts na significant figures approximation. Hindi kasi naghahanap ako ng material na pinag-uusapan niya ng maayos eh. And yung pinakamalinis na, yung pinakamalinis sa elementary treatment, yan. Okay.
Wala pong lumal. Ayun, kaya pala.
So, pa-download lang. So, yan, sisimulan natin yan ngayon. Tapos, ano ba yung last na ginawa natin?
Baka 3 po, hindi 3. Hindi po 3 na number. Crazy.
File sorting. Kasi pag inano mo yan, kapag ang ginamit mo ay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 11, 12, ganun. For example, yung ano, yung 2 at saka 20, ipagsusunod ng file browser eh. Hindi niya inaano na numerical counting. At least pag ganyan, sure na mauuna yung 2 sa 20.
Opo.
Okay. Tapos, share ko lang yun. No? So, buksan ko na rin yung PDF. Yung, ano to, scans to ng libro. Wala akong...
Scan po to? Hindi po to digital?
Hindi siya digital. Scan yun ang libro ko.
Na very good naman po. Very good quality.
Medyo mataas yung resolution na ginamit ko eh.
Mabok.
Kaya laki rin ng file. So, ito. Share. Ito. So, dito tayo magsisimula today. So, share ko lang yung screen ko, no? Window. Okay. So, yung topic ay approximation and estimation. Actually, sa pang grade 7 to sa Singapore. Kaya lang, nung tinitingnan ko kasi yung discussions sa ibang books, Young and Friedman at saka yung Resnick, Haldane, Walker, ina-assume na alam mo na to. Tapos yung hindi ko alam kung kasi di ba usually may na-encounter mo na ba yung significant figures at saka yung rules for significant figures?
Abo.
Okay. Ngayon, ang problema ko sa ganung sa typical treatment noon, hindi na pag-uusapan yung reasons bakit may ganung rules. Tapos yung so gusto kong idaanan lang natin. Tapos yung idea ng approximation and estimation kasama din to kasi yung problems ng chapter 1 ng Resnick, Haldane and Walker is actually a lot of this. Yung scientific notation, meron akong ibang section na isa-send next time. For today, this is what we'll do. So, approximation, estimation, and then we'll talk about rounding off what we're doing. Kasi tingnan mo yung ano niya, yung blurb dito ay when asked for the exact amount of time you take to get to school, would you reply with an exact figure? such as 29 minutes and 11 seconds? In this case, the common reply would be about 30 minutes. So in our daily lives, there are many occasions when we need to use approximation and estimation. So, punta tayo dun sa discussion yan.
Parang ano po yun?
So, ito.
Why are you 5 seconds late to school?
Oo nga. Hindi naman tayo na fractions of a second, di ba? Unless runner ka.
Opo.
Kapag marathons, importante yung fractions of a second. Pero, depende kasi sa use case eh. So, let's look at this article. Yung class discussion niya. So, read the article and answer the questions. So, Changi Airport. Ayan. Okay, so pwedeng mong i-screenshot ito. Tapos nun, tingnan mo, i-share mo yung para nasa notas, sulatan mo yung sagot mo. Habang para masulat mo yung mga sagot mo on the screen. Okay. So, sabihin mo lang ako kung ready ka na.
Handle something 2010. Okay, something 2009. Blah blah. Business Airport World.
Uh-huh. Teka. So pwedeng pa screenshot tapos ilagay mo sa bukas ka ng Google.
So basically po the first paragraph is useless and pointless to the actual mathematical problem. Oh, the entire article is useless except for the something passengers. Okay. Identify the numbers from the actual blah blah blah. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, hindi. Importante yung buo. Kasi ano yung mga exact numbers, ano yung mga ano dyan. So, may... Tapos, ano yung approximation, ano yung exact. So, for example, so ano yan eh. So, pwedeng pa-screenshot nung article, anong questions, tapos para mas mabilugan mo yung mga approximate.
Apo.
At ma-compare natin.
Pwede na po
ako
mag-share?
Oh, go ahead. So, stop sharing na ako. Tapos, so, para lang magsulatan mo yan. Okay. So,
why does the highlighter literally not highlight? It just replaces it. Okay.
Okay. Yung 42,000... 42,038,777. Ano yan? Exact? Approximate? Or wait, actual value?
Exact po. Oh, wait.
So, actual, it's an actual value. No?
Ay, actual po. Kasi yung literal number of people. This one, approximation. Okay, exact. Lahat po na numbers?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'm leaving all the years. Just to be sure na lang. Just to be sure. Okay. Over. No.
Mm-hmm.
No estimation. Okay, good. Hopefully the years are actually not counted anyway, doesn't matter. On something, date? Discounted, I don't know. Never mind. Still matters. Remember, this is the July matter, no? currently something something budget what? Budget Aoi. What? Oh, okay. There are secret numbers. So there is a one term. Maybe this could be counted. There are hidden numbers. Hidden. Okay. Brings total annual what? 73. Oh, easy. Somehow.
Okay. So, tingnan natin yung ano, no? So, kung na... hindi, sige. May encounter naman natin yung significant figures later. So, we'll look at the... So, why does the article mention over 360 awards instead of specifying the actual number of awards won? Ano kaya?
Para lang, is the saying over 360 awards. How do you say it? To give glory to the airport, at the airport. Not really, they don't have to specify, oh, it won 365 of. It just means na it has won many awards. More than 360 gives that picture that there it has won many, many awards already. But there's actually no reason to state the exact number of awards.
Mm-hmm. Okay, tapos, why does the title of the article use 42 million passengers instead of 42,038,777 passengers?
Because 42 million, because the title po, I think, but not really, I think. Objectively, the title is saying that in layman's terms, this airport handles literally many people, 42 million passengers. 42 million is easy for the mind to digest. While 42,038,777 is actually unnecessary, but maybe they placed it there in the actual paragraph because that's the actual data, so whatever. But the title says 42 million because 42 million is easy to interpret, but at the same time, it's close to the actual value.
Okay. At saka, ano rin eh, di ba? Yung usually mga headlines gusto mo as short as possible.
Short as possible, yet.
So, that's also one. Kasi kung newspapers, limited yung headline space eh. Kaya kita mo minsan yung grammar or minsan may mga ambiguous headlines na kakaiba. Okay, let's go to the next part. So, yung sa next page, ang pinag-uusapan ay, so, punta tayo sa PDF. So, sa next page, we'll just do a recap of rounding off. Tapos, para lang makita mo yung process. And then, So, let's just read this. So, let me share my screen. Okay, so we have learned in primary school how to round off numbers to the nearest 10, 100, and 1,000. So let's round off each of the following numbers to the nearest 10. So, tingnan natin 275 and 273.1. So if we look at 275, so look at the under, so dito yung process niya, nasaan yung tens digit? So underline. And then ano yung katabi? Tapos may yung algorithm ay 5 or more, add 1. If it's less than 5, gawin mo lang, don't change the digit.
Bakit po yung mga engineers
nila? So since 5...
Even number
ewan ko sa kanila. I think mas sensible yung ganitong rule kasi pag counted yung zero as a digit eh.
Aba.
Anyway, so pag 5 or more, so 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that's 5 digits, di ba? Pag 0 to 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's also 5 digits. So kapag kapag ang nandito sa 5, tapos wala nang kasunod, yung iba kasi naglalagay pa na, ah, pag may kasunod, may ganitong rule, which is confusing and doesn't really do anything. Kasi nag-introduce ka lang ng, hindi, yung rounding off is already an approximation. Eh. Okay, so tingnan natin, no? So, 5 or more, add 1, and then put a 0. So, naging 280. Yung 273.1, so, that's below 5. So, it doesn't matter kung anong kasunod. So, hindi na yung babaguhin, going 0. So, 270. Okay. So, let's just look at yung attention box dun sa side. 275 is exactly midway between 270 and 280. By convention, so ito yung importante, it is rounded up to 280. If step 3 is omitted, 275 equals 28 to the nearest 10, which is wrong. Since the degree of accuracy is specified, we use the equal sign. So pwede mo isulat yan, 275 equals 280 as long as merong naka-parenthesis to the nearest 10. If the degree of accuracy is not important, we will use the approximation sign. 275 is approximately 280. Okay. Yung other thing to note is 273 is nearer to 270 than to 280. Thus, 273 is rounded down to 270. So yung anong gagawin dito sa midpoint convention, ah, ilapit natin sa round off to 280. I think yung may mga additional rules na pag 5, tapos yung kasunod even, kasunod odd, has to do with this. That exactly at the middle yung 5 if you look at 270.
But why po? Why would you introduce such a rule? It's absurd.
Hindi, kasi no overweight towards rounding up. Let's cycle numbers na gagamitin sa computation. Tapos, yung number mo, mostly, may maraming 5. So, ma-overweight na, mas marami yung nararound off to 280. Kasi, what if 275 times 10?
2,750.
Ngayon, pag ni-round off mo 275 to 208 to 280 times 10.
2,800.
Mm-hmm. So, pag ni-round off ka ng 2,750, tapos sa pag ni-round off mo 'yan, mas na-round up to 280. To 2,800. Mas nawa-bias yung rounding off to one direction kesa the other.
Ah, para even po yung bias.
But that effect, oo. So, that effect, we usually ignore naman kasi hindi tayo expect na marami na that will often be the case. Eh. And the simpler the rule, the easier it is to implement. So we're sacrificing some accuracy for ease of use. Kaya ganyan. Okay, so punta tayo dun sa ano. So dito, yung practice now 1, pwedeng pagsagutan yung parts 1 and 2. And then patingin ng solution mo. So, stop sharing na muna ako tapos copy-paste mo sa ano. Actually, yung 1 is mostly to review rounding off. Yung 2, yan yung importante sa akin na matutunan ngayon eh.
Round off something to the nearest 10, then away.
Okay.
Singapore, welcome something visitor. So be nice. This rounded to the nearest something. What are the largest, smallest part? Okay.
So ang assumption dito, your fall na yung number niya nakuha from rounding off rules.
Oh no. Okay. So this is a rather unique problem. The value has been rounded. Okay. So okay, but 5. Then begins with the 5 and then it ends with the 5. Okay. Small, largest muna. 1 to the nearest. Okay. So 1 1 5 9 t. Wait, no. Largest number 9 9 9 9 9. Okay. 1 1.
Okay, bakit walang 0.000? Kasi because, pwede rin naman yan.
Because the no visitor will show up with no visitor will show up po in a half.
Okay, sige.
Exact number po. Okay, something. 1 1 5 5 0 0 0 0 wait. I think this is a rather naive approach. There's something deeper. Here, when it's rounded to 1,000, it hit the next one. So it became 1. Okay, so wait, let's see. If it's 1, 4 name. Okay, name. Nearest one. 1, 5. No, yes, okay. It's really like that. But why should it become black?
Let's work on a simple simpler problem. Huwag mo na yan.
Aba.
What if ganito? Pag ni-round off 130.
Round off 130.
Pag ni-round off. Rounded na po yung 130 na po.
To the nearest na po.
The nearest 10 siya.
So, largest 129, obviously. And then, smallest is 125, I think. Yes.
Paano yung 131?
Sasi! Reason why half of the students will literally fail. Okay, that was an inquisitive question. Wait. So this is one. this blew my mind honestly. Okay, so wait. Okay, so in that question, I would have.
You what one three?
Okay, so 116. Then we'll make it round off. 149. Wait, yes. Oh wait.
Mm-hmm.
Ah yes. Correct. Okay, so
round off mo yan, matatanggal yung 4 eh.
The small 155999. Okay, doon. I think. Wait, yes. Oh wait, no. It's looking for the smallest.
Okay, yung 11,550,000. Mhm.
Smallest. 5.
Pag ni-round off yan, maging 11,600 pa rin, di ba?
Mabo. I think that's it because the criterion is for it's great. The criterion is this digit must be 5 somehow. Mm-hmm. That's really the smallest number. Okay, this one.
Oh,
that would be either 5 or 4. So before 5. So this is really the last one. Okay. I think that's correct.
Okay. Oh, sige. Paano kung ano, if it, what if you're measuring something na when may decimal places na? Ito kasi visitors, yan yung natural talaga. Largest possible number of visitors, smallest possible number of visitors, consistent with rounding off.
Pero well, may mas kasi na. Kung let's say, yung ano po, yung tao kasi made up of cells, tanggalin na po yung isang cell. So, 0.9999 lang po na person. So, counted pa rin.
We're talking about visitors dito. What if we change the problem? What if we're talking about length?
May decimals. Okay, so 116 overseas tractors or something, whatever. Overseas cakes or something. The something that can be cut.
Tingnan natin. Yung, what if yan, that's in meters.
Meters ka lang.
So 11, 6.
6.
So ano yung largest possible length?
20 kilos.
Mm-hmm.
And then, why do I use the decimal point? I'm so used to the European style because I'm using yung European po na version ng ano eh. Okay, so 0. Yes, that's really it. Okay.
Okay. Ngayon, yung 11649999.9 na continuing yan. What number is that?
Oh wait, that's no. This is fake. This is a fake. This is a fake number because this is 6. This is wait, but 0.9999. 0.9 repeating is 1. So therefore this is 11.65. Yeah, 11,650,000.
Yeah.
Oh wait. Okay, wait. So kung 99999. So, yung ano doon, hindi siya pwedeng 88888. So, 98 will be greater than that. 989998 or something, whatever. An infinite number.
Kasi ang ano yan eh, we're not counting discrete objects ngayon. So, there's no largest possible, yung largest possible number na consistent. If you round it off, will not give you 11,600,000.
Oh no, it's impossible. So this time it is impossible. Oh. Okay, it is.
So yung ano niyan, yung least upper bound lang niyan is 11,650,000.
Oh no, a paradox.
So usually kinoconsider na yun. So 11,650,000. Yung smallest largest possible.
Smallest
kasi
large.
Okay. Parang siya, parang siyang naisip po, ano mong ang problema kasi, di ba? Infinite decimal siya na recurring. Para siyang, alam mo yung 0.9999999 na dire-diretso lang, na which is actually equal to 1. So, dito, ang sinasabi, yung limiting case yan, yung 11,650,000. Largest possible is less than
parang ano nga
11,650,000.
Parang parang infinitesimally different.
It can get infinitesimally close to 11,650,000. So, kung halimbawa, if x is the length, then yung inequality is x is greater than or equal to 11,550,000 and less than 11,650,000. Hindi mo siyang ma-equal, pero you can bring it arbitrarily close.
Is there a notation for that? Like, something, the greater than or less than symbol with some articulation or symbolization or something? Meron ba pang parang symbol?
Least, ano yan, may notation dyan. Least upper bound nung yung least upper bound nung number na consistent is 11,650,000.
So, sold na po talaga yung English.
Kung, if you're talking about notation. Walang plain English ano yan eh. It's math concept yung least upper bound.
Mm. Wala po siyang parang
so,
greater than or equal greater than sign po or something.
Oh, wala.
No.
Parang least upper bound. So yung siguro ito yung isang possible notation niyan. Share ko yung screen ko. Sorry, buksan ko lang yung notepad. Okay. So, yung numbers natin ito. So, yung X is approximately equal to 11 million. Any number? 11,600,000, diba? So, yung consistent with rounding off is X is an element of the interval.
Stop.
Okay na. So, sige. Ang kita yung screen ko?
Apo.
Okay, so we can use yung interval notation. So example, included yung 11,550,000. So kung sa number line, eto yon, included yung 11,550,000.
Tapos may hold.
Oh, tapos may hole sa 11 650,000.
Opo.
So, everything po, here.
Tinanong po, wala pong sinabing least na Sinabi lang po what is the greatest na ano, meron ba pong notation doon parang hole?
Ne, I think yung ano niyan, yung simplest answer to this one is include mo ng 11,650,000. So yun yung absolute na interval na possible.
Rounding.
Kasi you can bring it arbitrarily close eh.
Di kaya po ito, this is a rounding paradox. Kumbaga po parang, they are the exact same number and yet, they round to different things.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
So anything in between this interval sa number line will round off to 11,600,000. But we're talking about measurements that can be represented as points on a line, which mean measurements, yung measurements of length. Kung people lang, yun, yung sagot mo, okay na. Kasi yung lowest possible number of people, dapat counting number eh. Okay. So yung ano, yung how to get the number is teka. So ito yung ano, yung simpleng method ay if we're now going to include this, yung simpleng method para makuha yung range is tingnan natin yung kasunod na digit. So dito tayo magsimula. Buhayin ko to. 11,600. So, to produce the 6, ang mga natapyas yung nandito sa digits dito. Yung largest possible, so, pwede mo isulat as plus or minus 50,000. Yan. So, for example, yung 1.4, if it's rounded off, that's actually between 1.45 end, 1.35. Look at the next digit, tapos isulat mo as kung ano yung, so zero plus, so ito plus or minus 0.05. Teka, kita ba?
Apo.
Ayan. Kasi kailangan natin yan kasi pag what if nagmumultiply tayo, nag-a-add tayo or nagmumultiply tayo ng numbers na hindi tayo sigurado na obtained by writing off. Yung typical na questions ay, ano yung largest possible number na consistent with our, sa computation natin? The smallest possible number.
Mabok.
So for example, so ano ba yung example? Ay, may lalabas na example dito. So we'll encounter it as we go along the questions here. Okay, so let's look at another worked example in the book. So pero yun. So yung algorithm may kita mo na eh. Look at the next digit tapos plus or minus 5. Okay, so tapos po na tayo din sa book ulit. So let me share the screen. Para lang... Okay, so dito, so next work example is round off to one decimal place and the nearest whole number. I think na-encounter mo na to, so you can just look at, do it fast, read it fast, and then I'd like you to answer yung practice now too. So, number one muna. Tapos nun, yung number two, yan, we'll slow down on this. Kasi we'll have to talk about that.
Ano pa, hindi po siya nag-scroll. Ayaw po mag-scroll.
Saan?
Ito ba, yung document. This is the one to scroll. Ayun, this one. May napindot mo. Ayun, ayun. Circle next digit right nearest whole number the decimal place the first whole number 6 step do not add any what in alam ba siya what's wrong okay
you said
for you cannot get the 97 that points similar practice correct something copy paste
Wait, sorry. Ito maawag lang sa baba. Okay, so balik tayo dun sa ano, sa practice now 2. So patingin lang, so pag natapos ka sa number 1, patingin.
Ito mo. Ito ba number
1? Nasaan? Ang naka-share sa akin yung PDF eh.
Ah! Share. Wait lang po. Something is to see. Ito po.
Okay.
Tindi po yung mga skull.
Yeah. So, 78. Ayun. So, 78.5 to one decimal place. Nearest whole number. Nearest hundredth, okay. Nearest 0.001 4 7 0. Okay. Ngayon, yung number 2 naman.
when rounded off to 2 decimals. Well, that's true. But no, I don't agree because 8.40 means you are sure that it is 40, whatever unit, let's say meters. So 40.
Hindi, ganito. Ano yung large, pag sabi mong 8.40, ano yung largest possible value? Ano yung smallest possible value?
Ah, okay. I see. Okay, so...
Hindi, pasulat. Ano yung largest possible value? So 8.40 means the number is between...
Okay, so 8.40. Largest, 8.39. Hmm? Wait, no. Maano ko ma-solve. I will, my brain will be destroyed. Okay, 4.9, what, wait. Ah, yes, 4.9, the something paradox. Less than...
So, 8.
Less. Oh, wait, that's the wrong.
Pwede mo iso, just 8.45.
Less than 8.45, when this one is... 8.
Tapos ay yung...
rounded off to 2 decimal places. That seems rather sus for this because it doesn't have a second decimal place.
2 decimal places.
Does it have?
Let's say someone wrote down 8.40. Ano tapos di mo alam saan pinanggalingan. Ano yung largest possible value at ano yung smallest possible value? Para mag-round off na 4-0.
Ito mo. 8.35. So, 8 point something.
Teka. Hindi pwede kasi may 2 decimal places ka na eh. Dapat may additional digit. Pag yung additional digit, pag ni-round off, may iwan 8.40.
Wait a minute. Round down, yes. Okay, this one is round up. 399.9. Yeah, okay. So, talagang...
Wait a minute.
8.397. When it's repeating, it will equal 8.40 itself.
Hindi. Teka. Ang 8.397, pag ni-round off ba, magiging 8. So, 8.397. Ano yan pag ni-round off to 2 decimal places?
8.40.
Mm-hmm. Ang 8.398, pag ni-round off.
Pinahanap pa pala dito is smallest. So, hindi yung smallest. 8.87554.
So, 5. Tapos yung largest?
8.449 or de facto 8.45.
Hindi, 8.45 hindi pwede kasi pasok yung ano na yan eh.
Infinitesimally small po, smaller than 8.45.
Ano ba yung ano? For example, ang 8.401 pag ni-round off.
Kasi 2 decimal places eh. So dapat I'm looking at the third decimal place. Meaning yun yung itataas baba. So 8.4449.
Or pag
4049.
So 40. Hindi, okay na yung ano. Huwag mo nang kasi may bar dyan, di ba? So that's actually 8.405. So, ayan. So it can be arbitrarily close to 8.405. Ngayon, tingnan mo 8.4. Ano naman yung largest possible value at smallest possible value na consistent dyan?
So pag ganyan to ba, it means it was rounded to the first decimal place only?
Oo.
Ah, okay. May connotation na siya. Okay. If 4, 9.
Is there a lower number? For example, 8.38.
Wait, this is the, ano nga, this is the back to the paradox again. So, 0.95, yes.
Okay, so yung numbers, ngayon, yung may bar, so gawin na natin yan as 8.405 at saka yung isa, 8.45. So, let's just take note of that. 8.40 is a number between 8.405 and 8.395.
8.4 is between 8.35 and 8.45. Ah, yung accuracy so, na po yung precision actually, yung difference between the two.
Minus. Okay. Tingnan mo yan. Oh. So on a number line, ang 8.40, yung numbers na consistent with that is what? And then, on the same number line, ano naman yung numbers na consistent with 8.4? Yeah, so okay, so yung una, yung 8.40, yung consistent dyan is 8.405 at saka 8.395.
Diba?
Okay. Yung 8.4 consistent naman with?
With 4.335 and 4.35.
So, 0.35, 8.435, at saka 8.335. So, let's say may nagbigay sa'yo ng numbers. Forget about the initial problem. Kasi sabi lang, we measure the length. Sabi nung first guy, the measured length is 8.40. The second guy says it's 8.4. Tapos pareho silang tama. Ano ibig sabihin nun?
Pareho silang tama.
It what does it say about their measuring method?
Parang it brings new light, but so it means it is within this range.
So pag nag-report siya ng 8.40,
it's both
in sinabi nila, okay, I'm sure na it's between 8.35 and 8.45. Pag nag-report siya ng 8.40, I'm sure it's between 8.395 and 8.405.
Both of them are correct. They're just varying.
So if they're both correct, what the numbers actually tell us is, yung isa, yung accuracy niya, yung claimed accuracy is between 8.435 and 8.45. So yung first report, yung 8.4, my accuracy or my measured value is between this number. Yung 8.40, my measured value has a smaller uncertainty. So, yung writing na ganyan, so yung choice ng rounding off. Rounding off is actually a way to represent how sure you are about your measured value. Or how sure you are of your computed value. Okay. Ngayon, yung number of digits na you are sure of, ang tawag doon yung number of significant digits.
Abo.
So, for example, yung 8.395 si June Wayne, let's say sigurado siya sa measured value na 8.395. Yung number of significant digits is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yung 8.40, if someone reported that, sure siya na sa tatlong digits na yan, tapos hindi na siya sure sa next digit. Tapos yung 8.4, sure lang siya sa two digits na yan, hindi na siya sure sa kasunod. Okay, so okay na yan, no? So let's go to the next thing. Yan yung ano eh, yan yung point ng significant figures eh. It's a way to accurately, or it's a way to express how sure you are of a number. And then yung rules for significant figures, those are actually, gusto natin na we're computing with numbers that we are not 100% sure of. So yung result, how sure are we of the result? So for example, ito. Yung binigay, let's say ito, let's go back to these numbers. What if ang pinacompute sa'yo area? Yung side na minesure, si Carpenter A, ang na-measure niya with his instruments, 8.40 meters. Si Carpenter B, 8.4. Ano yung area?
Dito po. In between 395 and
4.3. Edge yan ng square.
Ito po.
Ang kailangan natin area ng square. So, kailangan mo ng calculation dyan.
Ah, may multiplication.
Tapos ano yun eh. Yung gusto kong gawin mo dyan ay, ano yung largest possible area na consistent? At ano yung smallest possible area na consistent? Okay.
Yung limita ka.
Kaya, saan yung calculate ko? So, let's say yung the size of a square may dalawang measurements na ginawa. Yung isa, minesure niya sa 8.40. Yung isa, minesure niya sa 8.4. Tapos, individually, kinalculate nila yung area.
So,
ano yung largest possible area according... So, tawagin natin si A. Carpenter A measures 8.40. So, pasulat lang. So, A measures 8... Si A yan. Si B yung 8.4. Tapos patingin ng calculation ng largest possible area according to A, largest possible area according to B, and then smallest possible area. So we have a square of side 8.4 as measured by A, is 8.40. As measured by B, it's 8.4.
It is the smallest, and then the biggest is.
Yeah. calculate ko rin. So 8 point, .395 square. Ito ang spalkin na to. .405 square is equal to 0.45 square, that's 71.4025 and 69.7225. Okay. So, tingnan mo yung calculated values ng ni A at saka ni B. Mas maliit yung possible range ng KA versus KB. So, yung computed values, you actually have to round off as well na in such a way na consistent with. Kasi, tingnan mo, what's 8.4 squared? And what's 8.40 squared? Compute mo sa right-hand side. Yung what if yung middle value yung ginamit natin?
Middle value.
So, what's 8.40 square? So, 70.56. Okay. Tapos yung isa, 8.4 square is, okay, it's going to be 70.56 din. Diba? So, pakisulat lang sa baba. And then we'll compare yung ranges. Yung area, so kung yung result, dapat i-round off mo to, kung si A yung tatanungin, gusto natin yung result is between 70.6 and 70.4. So, saan ka dapat mag-round off?
Second? Nano po?
So 70.56. Ano yung saan ka mag-round off? 70, sa 70.5? Or sa 70.50? Or... sorry, pag ni-round off mo yan, should you, according to A, yung calculated value is between 70.6 and 70.476, di ba? Tapos ang kinompute using the middle value is 70.56. Ngayon, if I round 70.56, round off, gusto ko na yung result will be between 70.64 and 70.47. Na, so best estimate.
Best estimate. Round
so up. Should I write it down as 70.5, 70.56, or 70?
70.5?
Pag 70.5, okay. Pag it's 70.55 plus 70.45, pwede. No?
Pwede na po 70.56 mismo. 7.66.
So, 70.6. Pwede rin. Kasi, at least pasok yung range. Eh. Yung 70 hindi okay na round off kasi ang lalabas yan between 70.5 and so tingnan mo yung mga ano, 70, 70.5, 70.6 kasi ito yung mga possible round offs eh. 70.56, so listen lang natin, 70.56
is to me.
So, palista. So, 70.56. So, on the side. Para lang, para makita natin yung choices. 70.56. 70.6. At saka, 71. Kasi, di ba, pag ni-round off yan, 71. Okay. So, to represent, to give some idea of A's calculation, what should I round off to?
Double.
70.6. Kasi, more or less, nabibigay niya yung range ng calculated areas, di ba?
Double.
Ngayon, pag ginagat mo yung 71, hindi pwede kasi masyadong malaking range kumpara sa calculated maximum and minimum area. Pero, pag tingnan mo yung sagot naman dun sa, kung yung consistent naman na round off for carpet for B is
six seventy one.
So yung 71 fits yung maximum and minimum possible area. Yung 70.6 doesn't. Which is, di ba, yung rule na yan, di ba, yung rule na mag-round off ka. If you have a product, round off to the smallest number of significant figures. Dito, yung sa A, we have 3 significant figures, it works. Pag 2 significant figures, we round off to 71. And the reason there's such a rule is goes back to ano yung largest possible area or largest possible computation or smallest possible computation. Rounding off is a way to keep track of that without having to do the computation itself. Kasi ayaw naman nating mag-compute lagi ng ano yung largest possible value nito. Ano yung smallest possible value. Gusto lang natin agamitin natin yung rounded off values and then round off na more or less consistent with the accuracy that we have. Anyway, we'll stop here. So, ang gusto kong gawin mo, do work, read worked example 3, yung next page.
This gave a lot of insight. Pakala niyo po if the significant figures are practically useless. But then they have...
May silbi yan eh. Kaya ito yung pinili kong, kaya kumuha ko from this book kasi napansin ko na it actually talks about yung why significant figures. Hindi to, di ba yung usual encounter na yung significant figures? Ito rules. Gamitin mo siya. Tapos walang, di mo maintindihan saan ang galing.
No ba?
So, ito yung ano, ito yung this is an elementary way of doing this. May mga mas sophisticated methods pa which uses probability.
Bro, imagine doing significant figures but then they said stop there. You need to use the binomial blah blah theorem.
Bro. So may mga ano eh, may refinements yan eh kasi minsan yung computation mo hindi siya equally kasi dito inassume natin yung round off equally probable sa next digit. Eh, paano kung hindi equally probable?
What? Anong klaseng, what kind yung... of mga rounding rules po na mga absurd? If it is 7, then don't round at all. If this is 4 for the 13 or something. Blah, blah, blah.
May ano, may refinements. So, syempre, okay. Hindi siya rounding off rule. It's more of magsiset up ka ng expressions na that will give you ito yung possible ranges ng sagot. So, I think this is actually the beginnings of yung understanding uncertainty. Kasi, yun naman yung point nito eh, na we're dealing with uncertain numbers, so you have to know how sure are you of your computed values.
uncertainty principle.
Yeah. Anyway, so we'll stop here. So paki-work ng worked example 3, tsaka practice now 3 on the next page, at tsaka gawin mo yung exercises sa 3A.
Nice.
Ubusin mo lang siya. Tapos think about yung ganyang effects. And then, yung advanced 7, tinatanong ka ng ganyan eh. Yung, tingnan mo yung sa 5, 6, 7. Do you agree with her? Explain your answer.
Bro.
Mga so, ano the exercises are meant...
More of philosophical, more of philosophical reasons. Practical reasons.
Kaya ano yan. So, next meeting talaga mag-uusap tayo about yung 5, 6, 7.
Na ba?
Tapos, and then we'll... So, huwag munang sabay nating babasahin yung significant figures, section 3.2. If you're looking for additional exercises, let's say naubos mo na yung 3A, yung pwede mong gawin, balik yung new syllabus additional math, balikan mo yung mga section, yung, di ba may mga ano, may mga exercises, yung new syllabus additional math na group by, ine, group by set A, B, C, D, E, F.
Nice. Aba.
Yun yung mga balikan mo. Just so you have, you still have practice on the earlier material. But that's, you only do that after you've worked through exercises in 3A. Okay?
Aba.
So yun yung homework. So work, practice now 3, and then exercises 3A. And then we'll talk about this on Saturday. Sunday. So, Sunday, 5 to 7 tayo, no?
Yes.
Okay. So, Sunday, 5 to 7. So, we'll see each other again on Sunday. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye po. Thank you po, sir.
Thank you po. Bye-bye. There's actually real use in the significant.